Alright, I'm gonna do a install video for the Cyclops CAN bus access controller. You can kind of see this. So we're gonna put this here under the seat and get all the wiring up. So let's see how she goes. All right, first part is taking off the seats. All right, first thing I'm gonna do is kinda get all the wiring kinda out. I'm gonna remove this plastic piece right here so I can kinda see what's going on and just establish all the wiring I need to hook up to this CAN bus controller, and then also figure out where to mount it. So probably gonna go somewhere in here, but at this point I kind of just want to get all my wires ready and wired up and see if I can clean up some of this wiring down here. Alright, so here's the Cyclops Raider system. So I have the, well, first I have Denali D4 auxiliary lights, so I'm going to put those to these two ports. We'll go through figuring out which wires I'm going to do that with here. And then also, I have the Evolution, Cyclops Evolution blinker system. Now what I was told is that I can kind of leave all of that alone and just tie in one of the white wires for the back brakes into one of these ports. Now I'm gonna have to take it out and look at it and see, but that should be doable. I'm not going to use anything for the heated jacket because I kind of already have that wired up right now, and I don't really like that you have to turn it on and off every time you get on the bike, because my system is just I plug it in and then I have a controller at the top of the bike to turn it on and off from, so I don't really need a knuckler mechanism. Spare port, I'm not sure what I'm going to use that for yet. I might just make it like an auxiliary power port, or see what else that I have that I can possibly run off of that. But this system should really help clean up my wiring. I've got a lot of wires directly connected to the battery here, and also back here on the main battery I've got a lot of wires connected here, and hopefully I can reduce that down to a minimal amount by utilizing this. So super excited about it. Let's work on getting the wiring. So this is the relay for the horn. I put an extra horn over here on the side because I wanted a little bit more noticeable audible tone when I hit the horn, because the stock horn is really weak. So kind of that's for me the whole purpose here is good visibility and good people hearing me. So this I might wire to the spare port. We'll see. I gotta look at what the horn is rated for amp wise, but I basically reduced this down a significant amount just to get to where it was stock, and some connections in here I reduced down to basically what's stock as well. And so what I'm gonna try to do is utilize this controller so that, you know, everything can kind of be wired up through there, and then I don't have as much stuff on my batteries and my other connections. As you noticed, I had a lot of stuff wired up, so this should hopefully clean this up significantly. Alright, so all this mess is for the auxiliary lights. Now, these actually go to the lights. So, I'm pretty sure I can get rid of this whole thing and just connect directly to these. I'm trying to, at this point, decide whether I want to cut these up to save these connectors, put them, you know, somewhere else, in case I ever need to put it back, or if I should cut these and utilize them to feed to the other part. But kind of leaning towards cutting these, because this one you're always ready to have one connection, and then I'm gonna have to make longer wires anyway to go over to here. So just getting a lot of wires in here, so I think I'm gonna start with cutting these back here a little ways, and just kind of keep all this stuff together. Alright, so gonna try to hook this up and just test out at least one of the front auxiliary lights and the back evolution lights. Kind of just, I like to do things a little bit at a time, so gonna hook this up straight to the battery. Got the fuse obviously, and then gotta hook this up to here. We're kind of gonna set it here and see what happens. Okay, so tried it out. I'll probably make a video once I get it all put together so you can kind of see what it looks like, but I at least tested out the connections here. So got the back blinkers running and then blinking when I applied the brake, and the front left auxiliary light came on, so looking good so far. Do some more wiring here and then do some little more testing and then we'll see how it goes. All right, so got this all hooked up, all the wiring's kind of laid out, got everything back together here. So just to go over kind of where I connected, so we'll see this. This is connected to the back rear Evolution white wire. You can see the white wire here. That one broke out from the original the original relay from one wire into two in the back, but this is sufficient power, so you don't even need a ground, you just need this wire hooked up. Okay, spare port I have hooked to the front Evolution lights. That does go to the relay that's in the front. Because I put the relay up in the headlight, then this power and ground is basically providing that power when that switch relays. These are going to my two auxiliary lights. I have Denali D4s. So they're hooked up there, and I'll work on programming those. And that's pretty much it. I am not using the heated output as of now, mostly because I like my heated gear to be on all the time. I have a pretty basic connection here, and I just plug it in and can control it from the front when it's on. So I wanted to hook it up to here, but not if I have to turn it on every time I turn on the bike. If it's kind of like the spare port and it's just on all the time, that would work a lot better for me. Okay, now we're going to go through programming sequence here. See that flash in the controllers working. So you have to start the bike. Suffocate myself. this was all the wiring I was able to reduce from the bike, which was pretty substantial. I'm pretty pretty happy right now. So save all this in case I ever need to take it out and put this stuff back in, but gotta reduce a lot of wiring in the bike, make it a little cleaner under there.